So hello guys and welcome back to another video. Today's video will be on the Toyota Fortuner. So before starting the video, make sure to follow me on Instagram. The link will be there in the description. And now let's start with the cinema.
Fallen one too many times. Feeling like another ends. Back again, square one. Try to leave myself behind. Looking for a better place, not to stay alone. Gain our trust and you chose to break it. Ask for truth but you only fake.
Hello guys and welcome back to another video. Today's video will be on the Toyota Fortuner. This is the key of the vehicle. From here you can lock, from here you can unlock, and from here you can open the boot. So first of all, let's see the headlamps of the car. So here you can see LED DRLs, and this is the projector headlamp of the car. Here you can see the fog lamp, and it is also a LED unit. Chrome lining over here, and here's the grille, which is again designed in chrome, looks very nice. Toyota logo over here and chrome accents over here as well. And this is the overall front look of the car. So let's move to the side, and you can see the wheels looks massive. So let's go to them. These are the Bridgestone dualer tires, and the size happens to be 265/65R617. So that is the thing. Side body cladding running all over the vehicle, and you can see the chrome window garnish and the chrome door handles as well. So that is the side, and let's move to the rear now. So this is the rear look of the car. You can see some aftermarket treatments over there, Fortuner written in chrome. Toyota logo looks very nice. This is the LED tail lamp of the car. So let's see the boot of the vehicle, and it will be opened from here, I think. So this is the electric tailgate on offer. After all the three rows up, you do not get a lot of boot space, but everything is decent. You can see, you can close it from here, and you get a handle as well. So that is the thing. And now let's check the space of the car. But before that, let me show you the side look. So here you can see the side look of the car. Looks very premium over here. So now we'll go inside the vehicle. So here you can see LED Fortuner's cuff plate, and you can sit in the car like this. So leather upholstery, and you can see you have a lot of leg room and knee room on offer. The headroom is also very nice. Here we go, this much of headroom on offer. Three headrests, and this is the central armrest as well. So that is the thing. You get AC vents on the roof, and this is the LED light. Automatic AC on the rear as well. This is the grab handle, and here is another grab handle as well. The central console, the dashboard looks very nice. You can see touch screen over there. So let's go over there. 12V charging socket along with some storage space as well. The hump is not much big. So now let's go to the front, and you can see request sensor over here. So this is the seat, 8-way electric seat. So let me push it all the way behind, and here we go. You can see AC vent over here along with the chrome accent, and this is the silver finish over here. Engine start stop switch, and these are some other things. Power door off, reverse parking sensor button. This is to open the fuel lid, this is to open the hood, and you can see the pedals over here. Scuff plate once again, and this is the driver side door. So this is the driver side door. You can see chrome over here, and these are some other switches as well. This is to adjust the ORVM, and these are the other power window switches. Now I'll show you some more things, and you can see this is the handle. So let me turn the ignition on. So you can see Fortuner's hello heads come all the way, and you can see everything over here, accessory. So you can control the MID from here, and we have to start the engine, I think. So here we go. The car is in neutral, so you can see everything over here, and we are releasing the clutch now. This is the tachometer. Here you can see the MID looks very nice, and let's go to the central console. So here you can see the clock. Now I'm turning the car off because it will take a lot of fuel. So here you can see the audio system. It does not get Android Auto or Apple CarPlay, but it does get a Bluetooth. So let's do the audio check. 90. The audio quality is really very nice. You can see airbag controls over here. These are the AC controls once again. 12V charging socket. This is the aux port. This is the USB port, and there is some storage space. Once again, here is the wireless charging pad. No, it is not wireless charging pad. And here you can see 5-speed manual transmission. No, 6-speed manual transmission, and we will turn it into reverse. You can turn it into IMT as well, eco mode, power mode, and these are the two water holders over here. This is the handbrake, which is finished in leather along with this chrome tip. And now we'll open the central armrest. So you can see a lot of storage space on offer, and you can see everywhere soft touch material is used. Looks very premium. Here's the Fortuner logo. So let's see the glove box. You can see a lot of storage space on offer. Looks very premium. And we'll go on lower glove box as well. This is lockable, so you can see a lot of space over here as well. But this is not cooled, I think. So yes, it is not cooled, but you get this grab handle as well. And this is the sun visor, so you get a mirror over here and a light as well. And you can see it looks very premium, light and all those things. Here a sunglass holder as well. And this is the passenger side, sun visor along with the mirror and the light as well. So that is the thing. And hard plastics are used in some places, but most of the places are used with the soft touch material. So that looks very nice. You can see the Twitter over here. And guys, that was my review of the Toyota Fortuner. I hope you have enjoyed it. If yes, then you know what to do. Give it a thumbs up or a Fanta, and make sure to subscribe the channel. Bye. I'm a fighter, trying to take me down, I'm going higher.